Hello, and welcome to Dashboard U, brought to you by Ross Video. My name is John Naylor. I'm the Marketing Product Manager for Dashboard. In this video, we're going to take a tour of a complete custom app from the user's point of view. The source code for this application is available for download on our website so that you can dig underneath the hood and see how it was made. This particular application is a cricket scoring app that allows somebody to score a cricket match and automatically create the right sort of graphics or the right data for graphics to drive XPression. Let's have a look. So here's our application, and I'm going to full screen it by Shift Command F11 on my Mac. This is the first of two tabs. You'll see it's the Teams tab, and the idea here is that before the game starts, you come and you set up the teams. This one looks more like South Africa than New Zealand to me, so I'm going to change that there. And you'll see we've got England now versus South Africa. The next thing we do is select how many overs per inning. And the minimum that's really played internationally is 20 overs, but to keep the demo short, I'm going to leave it at 2. And then we initialize the game by saying new game. In a cricket match, there'll be a toss, and the winner decides which team gets to bat. So let's just say that England won the toss and elected to bat. We'll press this button, and what this will do, it will reveal the scoring tab so that we can actually score the match. Here's a scoring tab. We've got something that looks like a cricket scoreboard here, and then the controls for responding to what happened in the game here. So this is where the operator would keep score. And this region below, we've got the graphics controls along with a tally message in the middle to tell us that we're currently safe, that the graphics are off air. So we've got two batsmen, Naylor, that's me, and Boycott, my boyhood hero, batting number two, and a couple of bowlers from South Africa facing us. So one of the kind of graphics that you might want to have as the bowlers running up to the batsman to deliver the first ball would be to put bowler to batsman. So we've looked by pressing this button, we've automatically generated the correct text, and we can take that. And you see we've got our virtual output, has got Abbott to Naylor, there's a lower third graphic there, and our tally has gone red. I can clear that, our tally goes green, and our virtual output of expression disappears or clears. Other things we can do, we can bring up the batting analysis. At the moment, it says England are 0 for 0 because there's not a ball being bowled yet. And you can clear that away. And now let's go and imagine something's happened. So Naylor's on strike and he's scored a 6. That's awesome. The next ball, though, he's LBW. So now England are 6 for 1. That's reflected on the scoreboard here. And we can go and get the batting score as a graphic here. So England 6 for 1. Let's take it as a graphic and clear it. Let's look at what the last man was. So it says Naylor, LBW, bowled Abbott for 6. Let's take that as the lower third and clear it again and have another look at the batting analysis. So you can see that now the batting analysis has changed to show Naylor's demise here. Now that Boycott, now Trott is on strike. Let's say he scores a single here, bringing Boycott onto strike, and he's just going to pad away the rest of the balls in the over. So that's our first over bowled, and you can see that the strike lights have changed to show that Trott is now on strike, and Sotsobe, the new bowler, is on strike here, or he's the active bowler. We're still safe, but if we go bowler to batsman, you'll see it's Sotsobe bowling to Trott. Let's take that, clear it. So you see how the data that you want to put on the graphic is kind of automatically tracking with what's happening in the game here. Let's give him a run, and then let's have some justice for Boycott. Let's run him out. So put the run out, and this is where we get into a one of those modal dialogues. Who was run out? Boycott was. Let's say he's done, and now the last man says Boycott run out for a duck. You can go and put that graphic up there if you want to, and take it, clear it, and show the batting analysis now has got more action on it there. And let's close out the game by having a slogfest. Five balls left in the over, six, 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 and a four to finish. End of the innings. So now we can look at the batting score. England 36 for two. Let's take it as a graphic, clear it, and move to the next innings. And now you'll see the scoreboard flipped over. South Africa now batting, England are bowling. So if you go bowler to batsman, you can see it's Finn to Chappell. Let's take this, let's clear it, and let's have them score some runs. Take a wicket, take another wicket, score some more runs, have a dot ball, maybe a wide, a few more runs, and we are down to South Africa 20. Can they make it? Let's have a look at the target. South Africa needs 17 off one overs. We're actually into the last ball of the over, so they're not going to make it. Let's take it anyway, clear it, and let's say the guy who was on strike, Morris, let's say he slogs for a six, then that's our game over. And we can presumably get a result here. No, I didn't put a result into this this demo app. But so we can look at South Africa's batting analysis and England's. Look at England's bowling analysis. A couple of wickets for Anderson and Finn. And South Africa's bowling analysis. Sobhi and Abbott getting a wicket each. And let's take ourselves off the air. We're now safe. So that's a tour of the cricket app. As I say, it is available for download. You can go and look at the code, see how this was done. And let me just take it out of full screen. Let's press the escape key twice to do that in this version of Dashboard 6.1 beta. And there we are. Thanks for your attention. Thanks for watching this video from Dashboard U. Come back often to see what other videos we make. And remember that Panel Builder is so simple to use that even the marketing guy can do it.